Your workforce scheduling software manages employees and shifts, but your users want you to add a button to automatically assign shifts to employees to generate the optimal schedule. Sounds easy, right? Until you get a list of all of their scheduling constraints. In this video, I'll show you how to solve it using Timefold. Let's take a look at some of those constraints. Here we have a schedule, and then you can see here we have a number of unassigned shifts. So here we have a morning shift, an afternoon shift, and a night shift, and so forth. And each of these shifts needs to be assigned to an employee. Some of these shifts require a skill, one or more skills. For example, this particular shift requires an anesthetics skill. So let's take a look at the employees. Here we have a number of employees, and each of those have skills. And for example, Amy Smith has that anesthetics skill. So we could assign her to that particular shift. That's a hard constraint. Also, we have for each of the employees availabilities. So for example, you can see here that Elsa Lee is not available on this Friday. If we scroll down, you also see that some of the other employees are not available on other days like Hugo here. Some of the days they prefer not to work, and those are marked in orange. Those are undesired skills. That's a soft constraint, while the unavailability is a hard constraint. And then also sometimes they want to work more, and then those days are marked in green, as you can see here. So that's the availability constraints. Now, if you actually solve this, let's do that. And now that we've solved it, what you can see here is that all of the shifts are assigned and to an employee. And also, no employee has two shifts at the same time. So let's take a look at that. You can see here that no employee has two shifts at the same time. So this is a good schedule, which takes into account all of the constraints. To generate a schedule under all of those constraints, call Timefold with your unassigned schedule, and then get back the optimized shift schedule. You can either use the Timefold Employee Scheduling REST API or build your own implementation using the Timefold Open Source Solver. To use the Timefold REST API, send in a JSON dataset of unassigned shifts, employees, availabilities, and other relevant information, and then get back the solution as JSON. You can call this from any programming language. Let's see how the JSON data looks like. So you can send in a list of all of the employees and all of the shifts, and optionally also the contracts which determine how long each employee can work. Now, if you look at the employees, you can see here we're sending in an employee called Elsa Green, and also an employee called Elsa Lee, and so forth. And each of these employees has a number of skills. So for example, this employee is a supervisor, has this particular certificate, and so forth. And of course, she also has a number of other properties. And one of them is, for example, the unavailable time spans when she cannot work. In this particular case, we're saying that this person cannot work on the 6th of November, right? From midnight to midnight. But you could make that half a day if you wanted to, right? Now, besides the employees, this is a long list of employees. There's also a long list of shifts. For each shift, we define when the shift starts, when the shift ends, and we can require a number of skills. Like here we need a volunteer, here we need an employee that has a psychology degree, and so forth. And then of course, the system will actually assign each shift to one of the employees, taking into account all of the constraints we talked about earlier. Alternatively, to use a Timefold open source solver, you need to use Java, Kotlin, or Python. First, add a dependency in your code. Then define and annotate your domain model to let the solver know what it can change. Next, define the constraints so the solver knows which solutions are better. And then call the solve method with your dataset to get the solution. Let's see how that looks like in code. So you go to the Timefold Quick Starts repository and clone that. In there, you go into the use cases directory. And in the use cases directory, you go to the employee scheduling example. You can find instructions here how to run it on your machine immediately. Now, when we actually look at the code, you will find that in the code there are some domain classes which define the employee, the shifts, and so forth. But you also find the employee scheduling constraint provider which defines all of the constraints. Let's take a look at one of those constraints, the required skill constraint. In there, we say every time we have a shift where the shift is assigned to a particular employee, that employee has a list of skills, that if that list of skills does not contain the required skill by that shift, then we're going to penalize the score with one heart. And this is how we tell Timefold Solver not to assign shifts to a particular employee that doesn't have the skill to do that shift. Similarly, you implement the other constraints, and if you want to learn more about this, take a look at the code. And that's how you generate an optimized employee shift schedule in your software. Just add that generate schedule button. Take a look at our other videos to learn more about continuous planning, publication notices, and dealing with unexpected changes.